throw a game genie on that bitch.
Thank you. motherfucker. the 90s were a big time for me. I was a teenager, you know, finding myself. Really fell in love with a lot of rock of the era. Stone Temple Pilots, Korn, System of a Down, Nine Inch Nails, Marilyn Manson. But my biggest passion in the 90s was video games. I adored GamePro magazine. I collected every issue, and I had a Sega Genesis with a 32X, and I adored all of the games. Mortal Kombat, Streets of Rage 2, Sonic the Hedgehog 1, 2, 3, and Knuckles. All of them. I stayed indoors and I played video games until my controllers broke and I had to buy more. So I just...
Oh, fuck. I've been working on this little game project for about 2.5 years. I still sleep at my desk instead of my bed because I just don't want to go to bed knowing that it ain't done yet.
Darkness, goth. I'm really passionate about finding what makes people tick, finding what makes people feel. I want to get to the bottom of things.
Support of friends and family, being true to myself, love, animals.
I personally love body modification because it allows people to express themselves in a unique way that other outlets can't. Tattoos are forever with minimal exception, piercings, tattoos, scarification. They all involve physical pain to a degree, and many people choose self-expression over physical pain and are not dissuaded by that. It gives people newfound confidence or allows them to carry on a memory or a symbol for something impactful in their lives or even a way to collect art on their bodies. I'm glad that body modifications are more widespread and less stigmatized than they once were because I find them captivating.
Favorite video games of all time was Double Switch on the Sega CD. I was a huge Corey Haim fan, and I couldn't believe that he was in a video game that I was playing. I was a huge fan of his work. I loved his roles in Lost Boys, License to Drive, and even his later not-so-well-known films, such as National Lampoon's Last Resort and Prayer of the Roller Boys. I lived in a one-room basement apartment with my parents as a teenager as they saved up money to purchase our first house, and playing full motion video games just felt like real life to me. It felt like I was interacting with these people, like Corey Haim was a buddy of mine, and I was helping him escape from these traps in the Edward Arms Hotel. It had a very grand feeling to it to me, coming from a small one-room apartment. And till this day, I think full motion video holds a great place for me in my heart. And now with the new technology, hopefully they bring it back in some facet someday.
There is no hard science that explains why people love flowers. I personally cannot think of one occasion that someone would use flowers out of spite or hate. Flowers are brought to hospital rooms to help speed recovery time. We send arrangements to say I love you or sorry. Brides walk down the aisle with bouquets and then tossing them after the celebration. We help those grieve who are in mourning. Everyone has a favorite flower, even if they might not recall the name by it instantly. We eagerly wait for our blooms for signs of spring. Spend time in gardens. Some wouldn't even exist without our help. We create perfect environments so they can thrive simply because they bring us joy. They are resilient and grow between cracks and sidewalks. Petals are picked out of innocence to ask, "He loves me, he loves me not."
thing I really like doing is drinking coffee out of my Repo Man coffee mug. Like a lot of people, I don't like getting out of bed in the morning. But drinking coffee out of my Repo Man mug gets me motivated to take on the day. The mug has a picture of Emilio Estevez on it from the movie Repo Man. He's dressed like a grocery store clerk. It's from that scene where he quits his job. He has a grumpy look on his face that perfectly expresses how I feel when I wake up. But after a couple cups of coffee, my life seems a lot more doable. I love this mug so much. It's easily my favorite coffee mug, which is saying a lot because I also have a coffee mug that was designed by David Lynch. It's the best $10 purchase I've ever made, and I've considered buying a second Repo Man mug as backup just in case anything were to happen to my current one. I can't adequately explain how happy this mug makes me. It's better than Prozac. Do they still make Prozac?